Have you ever attempted to update existing records within a Notion database? If so, you've probably recognized that it's a difficult process. To give you a quick example of why, let me import some data into this properties database. I'm going to come up here to the three circles, select merge with CSV, then I'm going to select a list of 50 properties, 25 of which are already within this Notion database. I'm going to select open and then start uploading. As you can see here, for the 25 properties that were already imported, Notion did not recognize that they are the same and has failed to update certain information, such as the home value increasing by $10,000. And we can also even see this by seeing that the same ID persists. You could spend hours manually cleaning up this data yourself, but let me show you a better way. To start, I've set this database back to the original 25 records. And now let's go over to the tool that we developed to help you with your Notion merges and imports. You can find the link to this application within the description of this video, and it's completely free to try. To start, I'm going to log in with Notion to give authentication to our databases. Up in the top right, you have the ability to choose which workspace you want to import data into. I've gone ahead and selected Space Loader. Now we're going to select the pages that we want to give the importer tool access to. I'm going to give access to the properties database that we've been working in and allow access. Now I'm going to select the database that I want to import data into, and I'm going to select properties, then select next. Now it's time to choose our CSV file that we're going to be importing. Here's the CSV data that I've been working with. This is the original list that I put in and their home values. And then if we come over here to the combined real estate properties tab, we can see those first 25. And all we're going to be doing for those first 25 is updating the home value. But at the same time, on the same import, we want to make sure that we're creating the rest of the 25 with their respective home values as well. To make sure everything's working for merging into existing records, let's take a look at 456 Maple Avenue. We can see that it's 790 on the new import we're going to do, but it was originally 775. So the expected behavior is that when we import this data, it should move to 790K. Coming back to the application, I'm now going to select Choose File and then select the combined list of all properties and select Open. Hit Next. Now it's time to map up our CSV headers with the Notion properties. So for name, I'm going to come down here and it's going to be name, ID, map that, and so on. Okay, now I've finished mapping up the properties and it's time to select a duplication check. And this is going to be a matching key to make sure that we're not creating duplicate records. Sometimes property names can be the same, so the best thing when you're working with importing CSVs, whether it's into Notion or any other software, is to find a unique identifier. For this test scenario, fortunately, we have ID to work with. And hopefully in the software that you're importing data from, you can also find that ID and make sure it's matched up on your CSV imports. All right, so I'm going to select ID and then select import. Now it's time to go over to Notion to see if the records imported successfully into our Notion database. And there you go, up to those 25 first records, we've successfully updated the home values without creating duplicates. And then we have also added another 25 new properties, giving us a count of 50. You can only imagine the time savings you experience if you're dealing with hundreds, if not thousands, of records within a Notion database that you're trying to update at one time. And unlike Notion's current import capabilities, we also give you visibility into whether or not you have any issues on your import. And you can download your results as a CSV and see row by row exactly what might have occurred if a record didn't successfully import. I've done hundreds of data imports into Notion and I'm already experiencing a ton of time savings for my clients when I'm utilizing this tool, and I hope you also enjoy it too. Thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe for more Notion content just like this in the future.